Rockin' with DJ Young Cash. What's swaggin', players? It's your boy Stax Montana, man. Back out here on my road to Madden 19 Career Mode Series, featuring my quarterback Alex Urban, aka the Chosen One, aka Mr. Dot Up Your Favorite Defense, as he dots up someone's favorite defense. You already know this man out here playing for them Oregon Ducks, aka them Score Again Ducks. And that's the name the media has given us because we've been going way too crazy these past few weeks. Like, we've been putting up crazy points. Now, when that happened, I already knew some things had to be changed. So we went from All-American difficulty up to Heisman difficulty. That's the highest difficulty you could play on. So from here on out, all you will be seeing is Heisman difficulty gameplay as I'm dotting up the defense again. And for some reason, my boy Breland can never get into the end zone. Like, he get us close enough. I mean, unless I'm dotting him in the end zone, he can never get us there. But it's all right. We came with a plan B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. We got all the backup plans. And your boy, let's go ahead and run that read option right into the end zone. Another rushing touchdown for this man, Alex. But yeah, this Heisman difficulty though, as you can see, Colorado done scored twice. We down by an entire touchdown just that quick. So we got the ball back, and the only thing on our mind right now is to become those Score Again Ducks, to go ahead and try to score again. We running that read option, second and three. Your boy is gonna barely get the first down right here. I'm like, oh my God. This Heisman difficulty is crazy, but you know, I'm committed, dog. And one thing I just want you guys to be on the lookout for, when we are playing trash teams, blowouts are going to happen. It's just going to happen. I'm sorry, nothing I can do about that. If I can score, I'm going to score right here. I tried to get behind my boy JJ before I got cracked right there. I wanted him to pick up a block for me, but it's all good. We got the first down, and we closer and closer to the end zone, which is obviously our main goal right now, to go ahead and try to score again. You feel me? But like I was saying, blowouts are going to happen. So, you know, that is just what it is. But anyway, back to this gameplay. Your boy rolling out the pocket, second and two. We found my boy Nelson, and I wish you would have hit him with one of them stiff arms that he hit that other guy with when he made that dude do a backflip. My guy, little Charles Nelson, hit a guy with a stiff arm so hard he made him do a backflip midway through the second quarter. And look at my boy JJ beating the defender off the line, getting wide open and getting right into that end zone. Look at this. That man got so much skill, and he a freshman. You already know that freshman to freshman connection, it go crazy, you feel me? So after the field goal, we was tied, but once we got the ball back, Colorado has scored again. I'm like, oh, Lord, this Heisman difficulty is something else, but it's all good. We ain't even worried. We ain't even nervous, you feel me? We just going to keep doing our thing, and hopefully we can get back into that end zone, you know what I'm saying? We definitely don't want to get stopped right now. We don't want to give Colorado all the momentum, you feel me? Even though they got some momentum brewing, we want to have some momentum brewing as well. My boy Mitchell grabbing the ball right there, getting up the field. Alex getting out the pocket, dotting that man up. He's seen him streaking across the field, so he kind of wanted to meet him on the right side so he could just throw him up the field a little bit. You know what I'm saying? That's just an old trick that Alex going ahead and keep in his pocket. Now we running them streaks. First to 10. Look who's wide open again. My boy JJ. Johnny Johnson III coming from Alex Urban III. That freshman to freshman connection. JJ wide open in the end zone. And I don't know how this guy keep getting open, but they need to start double covering that man on them streaks. And honestly, I don't know if they could do that because we still got Mitchell Dillon. He could get open on them streaks. My boy Nelson could get open on them streaks. But finally, our defense step up. We get a stop. So now we could get back into the end zone. We could be up a touchdown. But on 2nd and 11, your boy almost got sacked. Luckily, we tried to throw the ball to my boy Breland, but we got hit, so the ball went short. Nothing happened. Trying to find somebody, but look who I find. Nelson down the field. Mr. 99 speed, bro. Nelson coming up clutch, getting himself open, and getting into a place that Alice can see him, bro. Nelson is so fire when it comes to improvising on these routes, bro. He always making moves. Coach got us running this screen pass. This never works. We lose 7 yards. And I'm like, Coach, can you please stop calling halfback screens? They never work. Like, we cannot keep running this. It's detrimental to the team at this point. But at 3rd and 15, we trying to get into the end zone. This time they got my boy JJ coming across the middle. I wish they had him on the street. They had like 4-5 safeties deep. And then we just had to go ahead and take all the yards we could. We kicked the field goal. These guys got the ball back at halftime and scored again. We cannot lose to an unranked team. As your boy Alex scrambling for that first down, we just cannot lose to an unranked team. Dog, we moving up the rankings. This man Alex got this team from unranked, not thought about, to ranked top 16 in the nation. We just can't lose all of that right now. On 1st and 10, my boy Nelson dropped the pass right there. We ain't worried, but we definitely need somebody to come up clutch. 2nd and 10 this time. What can we do? Can we get a first down? Can we find somebody? And we almost found the defense. Almost threw an interception right there. That was close. 3rd and 10 now. We in Colorado. Their crowd is going crazy, chanting defense. Nobody is open. And your boy Alex runs right into a sack. We have to punt the ball. But luckily, our defense was able to stop these guys from scoring. Now that we got the ball back, we definitely got to do something. We don't want to go down by 2 scores. We do have more than enough time left in this game to score, so we're not worried. But we don't want to be in a position where we have to score twice to take the lead back. You get what I'm saying? So we got to try to get some type of points. Scrambling out the pocket. Who else but my boy Nelson improvising on a route once again. Doing his thing, coming up clutch. Shout out to my boy Charles Nelson, dog. Doing his thing and helping Alex out in his backfield. 1st and 10. Down by 4 still. We got to make a play immediately. And my boy Mitchell grabbing the ball. 17-yard reception. He's been kind of quiet today. Only 3 receptions for 53 yards. Kind of a quiet day for Dylan, but we're going to need everybody to step up at this point. Everybody got to be clutch. You know what I'm saying? JJ been doing this thing all game. We try to find him in the end zone, but we throw an interception. And that was the last thing we needed. Oh my God. But luckily, our defense was able to stop these guys. We got back on the field once again. We getting so many chances. And like I always say, bro, oh, did you see that dot? Did you see my boy Nelson? At first, I couldn't believe it, but after seeing his replay, he did get the foot down in bounds. But like I always say, we have the 6th-ranked team in the nation. So that means offense and defense. So right now, our defense is definitely playing like the top 16 team in the nation. Our offense, on the other hand, is playing great, but we have to play better. That interception was very costly. We can't turn the ball over no more, bro. Not in this point of the game. Like I said, we don't want to be in a situation when we are down by 2 scores where we have to score twice to take the lead, because Colorado, they showing that they can score with us. They can keep up with the points with us. And also their defense showing that we could probably lock y'all down. Right now we're running that halfback screen once again. It usually never works, but this time my boy Royce Freeman making some moves. The blocks were set up good enough for him to get the first down. And we close to the end zone. This is how the drive looked last time when we threw the pick. So we're not trying to be too impressed. We're not overzealous about this. We're just trying to keep the ball moving and get into the end zone. 2nd and 2. We run in the read option. That guy stays. So I hand it off to Royce. And he gets into the end zone. We finally score again. It took us all the way to the 4th quarter to score again. And then we got the stop. So we up by 3. If we can get a touchdown right here, we can make it a 2-possession game in our favor. So getting a touchdown right here is definitely on our mind. We definitely have to channel our inner score again, Ducks, to go ahead and try to get into the end zone. Your boy scrambling out the pocket. He didn't want to step up on me. He had to stay with Nelson, or Dylan Mitchell, should I say, because they are elite receivers, it's looking like. And this Heisman difficulty, bro, it's kind of tough, but I'm loving the competition. Look at your boy scrambling out the pocket, getting the first down and getting out of bounds. Most importantly, we don't want to take any hits. We don't want to fumble. We don't want to get hurt in this point of the game. So we got to take care of our body at this point. My boy Charles Nelson wide open for the grab, getting us another first down. Mr. Reliable Charles Nelson. So it shifted from my boy JJ over to my boy Charles Nelson. So everybody at any point can carry the team, just like so far in this game. The defense has been carrying this team, stopping these guys from scoring over and over again. This time my boy Dylan wide open. I wanted him to get into the end zone so bad right there to make this a two-score game for us, but it's all good. Second and 19. The blitz started getting into me. Scrambling out the pocket. We tried to make a play. We got hit when we threw and threw an interception. And that's the last thing we needed. Hopefully our defense can be clutch one more time. Which they ended up doing, bruh. Shout out to the defense, because without them, we definitely would have lost this game, bruh. Two interceptions from Alex. That's not likely. That's really not like him. We only scored 31 points. That's not like us as a team. But next week, we got to improve. That's Heisman difficulty, man. It's tough. But like I said, I'm liking the competition. My boy JJ wide open down the field. Shout out to my boy JJ. That freshman to freshman connection is crazy. You know what I'm saying? My boy JJ doing his thing. But like I was saying, bro, yeah, it's kind of crazy over here on this Heisman difficulty. We did our thing. We still got the W, though, so that's the most important thing. But if this is your first time watching the Stacks Montana video, man, make sure you go ahead and subscribe. You're not going to want to miss out on these fire videos that I got coming real soon, all of them, on Heisman difficulty. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and drop a like on it for me. I definitely do appreciate it. But until next time, players, real fans, stay up and I am out. Swag team, bruh. Zombie game, cuz. By the way, shout out to that defense once again, because without those guys, we'd have lost this game to an unranked team. It would have been devastating. So our defense stepped up. Shout out to those guys on the defense.